We're so glad to have you this morning to visit with us at the Fowler Avenue Baptist Church on Sunday morning. And we appreciate our visitors and guests coming in, looking and seeing what's going on here at Fowler. Right now, we're not able to assemble like we'd like to, but we've been able to keep a distance away from one another that we might be able to be saved. But it won't be long, we'll be able to come back together as a church where we can assemble. The Bible says, not forsaking the assembling yourselves together as a manner of some is, but so much the more as you see the day approaching. Right now, these are terrible days we're living in. And we want to realize that our Savior is the one that gives us hope and encouragement. And he has put forth the local church to assemble. But right now, we're not able to, but we can do it through the via of the airwaves. And we're so thankful for you looking at our video and some of the verses we're sharing with you. It'd be a tremendous blessing. What we'd like to look at today is, do you really know why Jesus Christ came into the world? But before we get into this subject matter, we'd like to go to the Lord in prayer, asking him to help us and give us strength and grace during these special days of anxiety, fear, and frustration. Our Father, we thank you that you're on the throne, that we're your children, you know all about us. And Father, we do pray for your protection, your provision. We thank you for your grace and mercy that you give us every day. And Father, this terrible virus is going around. Pray for your protection with our family, our church members, and those that may have it, you might bring healing to their bodies. And Father, we're just thankful that we come together and thank you for loving us and sending your Son to be our Savior. We pray in Jesus' name that you'll use this message to encourage the family of God. We ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Some of the verses I'd like to share with you today is, why did Jesus Christ come? Now, it depends on who you ask. One day, the Lord Jesus Christ asked his disciples, who do men say that I am? And they begin to say, well, one thinks you're John the Baptist that's been risen from the dead. Some thinks you're Elijah. Somebody thinks this or that. He asked Peter straightforward. He says, Peter, who do you say that I am? He said, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. And Jesus said, flesh and blood has not revealed this unto you, Peter, but my Father which is in heaven. I'm so thankful that God's grace is extended to all mankind. The Bible says the grace of God that bringeth salvation hath appeared to all men, teaching us that dying ungodliness and worldly lusts, we should live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world, looking for that blessed hope and the glorious appearing of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ. The Bible says this, we know that all of us have a sin nature and we're under the bondage of sin and corruption, whereas by one man sin entered into the world and death by sin. So death passed upon all men. So no matter where you go in the world, no matter the color of the skin, we all have the same problem. It's called a sin problem. The Bible says all have sinned. There's not a just man upon the face of the earth that sinneth not. We're all sinners, and God has sent his Son to redeem us by his blood and save us from sin. It's condemnation. It's separation from God. So we need to understand that this salvation that God has given to us is not in religion. It's not in baptism. But it's in a person. And that person is the Lord Jesus Christ. And what Jesus said to Peter is, upon this testimony, upon this word that you've given, I'm going to build my church. And so the church of Jesus Christ is built upon the solid rock, the Lord Jesus Christ. He's our rock. He's our fortress. He's our all in all. Some of these verses I'll share with you, you need to put them down, because I believe if someone asks you today, why did Jesus come? Why did he come? Well, we know he came because God sent him for a purpose and a plan. All through the book of Genesis, all the way through the book of Revelation, Jesus Christ will be the centerfold. He'll be the main picture that God wants us to see. And so we're going to look at a few of these verses, why Jesus Christ came into our world. One of the first things is found in 1 Timothy chapter 1, 11 through 17. Now, the verse that we look at is 15. This is a faithful saying. Excuse me. This is a faithful saying and worthy of all acceptation, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am chief. That's what the Apostle Paul said to Timothy. He says, Timothy, I am the chief of sinners. I'm the one who was religious but religiously lost. I was a man who was sincere but sincerely wrong. I was wrapped up in self-righteousness. I did not know Christ as my Savior. But on the road to Damascus is when he met his Savior face to face. Now, my question to you, when did you meet Christ as your Savior? Go down that road. Go down memory lane to the time and the place where you know that you know. I asked Christ Jesus to come into my heart and save me. I'm not trusting religion. I'm not trusting baptism. But Lord Jesus, I'm trusting you because I know that's why you came. You came into the world to save sinners. And the Bible says all of us are sinners because of Adam's condemnation and Adam's transgression was placed upon all mankind. All over the world, people are dying because the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Have you received that gift today? Go down memory lane to the time and place where you know you invited Jesus Christ into your heart to be your Savior. So we not only find this verse here in 1 Timothy 1, 11 through 17, according to the glorious gospel of the blessed God, which was committed to my trust. And I thank Christ Jesus, our Lord, who hath enabled me that he counted me faithful, putting me into the ministry. Verse 13, who was before a blasphemer, a persecutor, injurious. I obtained mercy because I did it ignorantly. I did it in ignorance and unbelief, spiritual darkness, spiritual deception. Well, I had religion, but I did not have Christ. And he says this, the key verse, and we'll move to another verse. He says this in verse 15. This is a faithful saying and worthy of all acceptation that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I'm chief. You can see, I know why Christ came. He came into the world to save sinners. He didn't come to be a martyr. He didn't become a religious teacher. He came to save sinners. We're all sinners. And number one, that's why Jesus Christ came. Aren't you glad? Number two, Jesus Christ came to save the lost. Luke chapter 19, 1 through 10. Verse 10 says, for the Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost. Matthew 18, 11. For the Son of Man has come to save that which was lost. So we found out in one passage that Christ came to the world to save sinners. Why did he come to save us? Because we're lost, separated from God because of our sin. The wrath of God. Did you know that a person without the Lord Jesus Christ, the Bible says he's condemned already. He's not going to be condemned. He's condemned already. Why? Because he had not believed on the name of the only begotten Son of God. That's found in John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son to the world to condemn the world, but the world through him might be saved. Isn't that wonderful? That's wonderful. He came to save sinners. He came to save the lost. He came for all mankind because all mankind, they're sinners and they're lost and need to be redeemed by the blood of Jesus Christ. Let's go to another verse, number three. Why did Jesus come? He came to save sinners. He came to save the lost. But here's number three. The Bible says he came to the world to save the world. The world of lost mankind. The world of lost people. If any man hear my words and believe not, I judge him not. For I came not to judge the world, but to save the world. A world of lost mankind all over. They're sinners by nature. The Bible says they're lost. And he came to save a world of lost sinners. Put that down. That's John chapter 12 and 47 through 50 and in verse 50. And another, number four, Jesus Christ came to be the light of the world. A world lost in sin. The darkness of sin shrouds the world of humanity. All mankind are lost. He came to save sinners. He came to save the lost. He came to be the light of the world. He came to illuminate you in spiritual darkness. The Bible says Christ Jesus came that he might take our sin away. Redeem us by his blood, that we might become children of God. By faith in Christ and his finished work, the Bible says we become children of God. Can you imagine you're a child of God by faith in Christ Jesus? God is your heavenly Father. He knows the things that you're facing every day. Jesus is a man who was tempted and tried in all points like us. The Bible says we have not a high priest who cannot be, listen, he knows your hurting places. He knows your problems, your pressure, your pain. He knows your discouragement, your defeat. He knows the good days, he knows the bad days. And right now you may be going through a bad day, or a bad week, or a bad year. But my Heavenly Father is in control of all things. He wants you to be encouraged, because he not only came to save us and redeem us, but he came to encourage you and strengthen you by helping you with your special needs. We find another one. He not only came to the light of the world to dispel. He came not to the world to condemn the world, but the world through him might be saved. He that believeth not is condemned already, because he had not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. John 3:36 says, he that believeth not on the Son of God, the wrath of God abideth on him. As you look at your children, your boys and your girls, what age are they? When they reach the age of accountability, they become responsible and accountable. How old are they? When you look at children who've reached the age of accountability, you look at all mankind. The Bible says, without Christ, the wrath of God is abiding upon them. And the one who came to take the wrath of God away was the Lord Jesus Christ, because your sin and my sin was placed upon him. And he, by the grace of God, tasted the death, the separation that we should have. He, by the grace of God, has tasted death for every man, woman, boy, and girl. Aren't you glad of that? We find out from these scriptures why Christ came. He came to be the light of the world. Now, Jesus came not to call the righteous. Now, these are Bible reasons why Christ came. I want to give you that verse. It's over in Mark chapter 2, verse 17. When Jesus heard it, he said to them, they that are whole need not a physician, but they that are sick. I came not to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance. He came for spiritual sick people like you and like me and the world of mankind. He didn't come to call the righteous, because the Bible says there's none righteous, no, not one. There's none just. There's none that seeketh after God. We're all sinners separated from God, dead spiritually, going to be made alive. And in Adam, all men die spiritually, but in Christ, all men are made alive, and we become children of God, and God becomes our Heavenly Father. Isn't that wonderful to know why he came? Not to call the righteous. There's none righteous. But I'll tell you what happens. When you receive Christ as your Savior, this is what takes place. I want to take my coat, illustrate this. The Bible says when you give the Lord Jesus Christ your sin, you say, oh God, I know that I'm a sinner. I know that Jesus came and died for me. And when you give Christ your sin, he took it to Calvary at God's appointed time and paid our sin debt in full. And when you receive Christ, the Bible says he puts his righteousness to your account. Can you imagine that? His righteousness, the righteousness of Christ, the righteousness of God. We have our righteousness are a filthy rag, but he gives us the righteousness of Christ when we receive him as our Savior. It was imputed. It was put to our account. We did not buy it. We did not earn it. We cannot work for it. For by grace are we saved through faith, that not of ourselves. It is a gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. He came not to call the righteous, but came to call sinners to repentance. That's what we are. Number six. The Bible says, he came that we might have life and have it more abundantly. Now, not only gives us eternal life and everlasting life, he gives us life abundantly down here right now. Where sin abounds, the grace of God much more, much more abound. And listen, he came us to give us life, eternal life, but he gave us abundant life, overflowing to the max, more than we can even compare and understand. He came that we might have eternal life, but the Bible says he came to give us abundant life. I find this over in John 10, looking at verse 10. The thief cometh not but to steal and to kill. But I am come that they might have life, and they may have it more abundantly. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep. But he that is a hireling, those who are just paid preachers and people sometimes that you look up to, listen. Jesus said, I came to be your shepherd. I came to be your redeemer. He says this, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep. But the hireling and not the shepherd, whose all the sheep are, when he sees the wolf coming, he leaveth his sheep, and the sheep fleeth, and the wolf catcheth them. The Bible says that in Christ we're safe and secure. I'm so glad that in Christ we have the hedge around us, the hedge of God. That day when God was talking to Satan, and God paraphrased, said to Satan, have you considered my servant Job, how he avoids evil, and he loves me, and he tries to serve me? And you know what Satan says? Yeah, I know Job, I know him very well. You put a hedge around him. Did you know as a child of God, you have a hedge around you that God has provided? And no one can get to you, nothing can get to you unless God has ordained or planted for his glory, for your good and the good of others. I'm so glad that he came not only to give us life eternal, but he gives us the abundant life, overflowing abundantly, one that has a hedge around it, one who's in the hand of God. My sheep hear my voice. I know them. I give unto them eternal life, and they shall never perish. Neither shall any man pluck them out of my hand. I'm in the hand of Christ. My Father which gave them me is greater than all. No man's able to pluck them out of my Father's hand. As a child of God, you're in the hand of Jesus. As a child of God, you're in the hand of God. And there's no power equal to God. And then you're also sealed with the Holy Spirit of promise. Right there you have God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. Gives you security. He gives you safety. He gives you protection. So these six things, and I think we'll just close right here. Our sermon varies. I got six more things I'd like to share with you about why Christ came. But I think that will be sufficient. Do y'all think it's sufficient? You think we're going to close out right now? Right now, we're so glad that we found out these six reasons, Bible reasons, why Jesus Christ came. He came because of you personally. His love for you. Here is love, not that we love God, but he loves us and sent his son to be the propitiation, the atoning sacrifice for our sin. And when God hath made him, Christ, to be sin for us who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteous of God in him. Listen, he's our Father. We have his righteousness put to our account. We're safe, we're secure. And he knows what problem you're facing right now. He wants you to be encouraged. And he's able to say, back off. This is my child. I'm his Father. And he takes care of his children. Aren't you glad of that? We're going to bow together in prayer, but we're so glad you could come today. Our Father, we thank you that we're all the children of God by our faith in Christ Jesus, believing that he is the Son of God. He did come from heaven to take our sin upon himself, go to Calvary, die, shed his blood. They placed him in that old dark, doomed tomb. On the third day, he rose again. Our salvation, our security, our all is in Jesus Christ. We're heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ. And all that God in Christ is ours. He gives us richly all things to enjoy. He wants you to be blessed. He gives us life abundantly. Thank you for being with us today. Amen.